Good morning. Welcome in the name of Christ. Welcome to our young worshipers, our adults, elders, friends, new and regular ones that have been here. And I invite you to take part in everything we do today. And welcome to those of you here for the first time and those of you here for the 1,000th time. It is good to be gathered on this fifth Sunday after Pentecost. Please turn to your neighbor and introduce yourself or say hello as I welcome folks on our YouTube live stream. Good morning. Thank you for joining us online. And I hope you're doing well. And you may find the worship folder link on our website. And please prepare bread, juice, or wine to join us in Holy Communion. If you are a visitor this morning, please take a moment to fill out a yellow card that you can find in the pews, and you can place the card in the offering plate when it goes by later in the service. And we also invite you to come up and bring your offering to Noisy Offering. So if you have a lot of coins, please share them with the young kids, or you can bring yourself your offering, and there'll still be offering plates going around. And also, we want to try something new. So there's scribble paper on your pew. So if you could write during offering, what are you grateful or thankful for? And just write that down and put it in the offering, and I'll be reading them and lifting up prayers. So you're welcome to do that as well. And we also want to pray for Mary Preuss and her sister, who will be leaving to France this afternoon to be with their brother Joel, who is in critical condition right now, and with his family. So please add them into your prayers for safe travel, and just be in together with Joel. And we are thankful to have Reverend Angela Kebab as our preacher this morning. Reverend Angela is an ELCA pastor residing in Minneapolis with her husband Benny Kebab and their three children, Konami, Kenna, and Connie. And they're an active member of Our Saviors. And she is an editor for a book that we will have lunch and learn after worship, and it's called To Allyship. And it's preparing your congregation for leaders of color. And she's an active writer for Living Lutheran, and so we're really blessed to have her here joining us for worship. Let us stand as you're able for a confession and forgiveness. Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God, who propels us toward righteousness and draws near to us with salvation. God of all,
you love justice and you hate wrongdoing. We confess the fear, greed, and self-centeredness that make us reluctant to work against oppression. We are complicit in systems of exploitation. We choose comfort over courage. We are careless with creation's bounty. Look upon us with mercy.
Make us glad to do your will and to walk in your ways for the sake of the beloved community.
Now is the moment. Now is the day of salvation. God quiets the storm and urges us to open our hearts to God and to one another. In the strong name of Jesus Christ, I declare to you the forgiveness of your sins. Thanks be to God.
Thanks be to God.
The grace of our Savior, Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
Let us pray. O God of creation, eternal majesty, you preside over land and sea, sunshine and storm. By your strength, pilot us. By your power, preserve us. By your wisdom, instruct us. And by your hand, protect us. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and God. Amen.
Amen.
Please be seated.
A reading from Paul's second letter to the Corinthians. As we work together with God, we urge you also not to accept the grace of God in vain. For God says, "At an acceptable time I have listened to you, and on a day of salvation I have helped you. See, now is the acceptable time. See, now is the day of salvation. We are putting no obstacle in anyone's way, so that no fault may be found with our ministry. But as servants of God, we have commended ourselves in every way, through great endurance, in afflictions, hardships, calamities, beatings, imprisonments, riots, labors, sleepless nights, hunger, by purity, knowledge, patience, kindness, holiness of spirit, genuine love, truthful speech, and the power of God, with the weapons of righteousness for the right hand and for the left, in honor and dishonor, in ill repute and good repute. We are treated as impostors, and yet are true, as unknown, and yet are well known, as dying, and see, we are alive, as punished, and yet not killed, as sorrowful, yet always rejoicing, as poor, yet making many rich, as having nothing, and yet possessing everything. We have spoken frankly to you, Corinthians. Our heart is wide open to you. There is no restriction in our affections, but only in yours. In return, I speak as to children. Open wide your hearts also. This is the word of life.
Holy Gospel according to Mark, the fourth chapter.
Glory to you, Lord God.
When evening had come, Jesus said to the disciples, "Let us go across to the other side." And leaving the crowd behind, they took him with them in the boat, just as he was. Now other boats were with him. A great windstorm arose and the waves beat into the boat so that the boat was already being swamped. But Jesus was in the stern asleep on the cushion. And they woke him up and said to him, "Teacher, do you not care that we are perishing?" Jesus woke up and rebuked the wind and the sea, "Peace, be still." And then the wind ceased, and there was a dead calm. And he said to them, "Why are you afraid? Have you still no faith?" And they were filled with great awe and said to one another, "Who is this man that even the wind and the sea obey him?" This is the gospel of our Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
I invite the children to come up with your parents or adult givers. Okay. Okay. Hi. Good to see you, Thomas. Yeah. Come on in. Hello. Okay. I'm trying to pull this really nicely for all of you. So what's this?
A towel.
That's right, a towel. But I fold my towel this morning. I fold it nicely for you. But what do you think this towel can do? Yes? It can dry you, correct?
But it's swimming.
Swimming. Okay, in the water so it gets wet? Oh, yeah.
Dry off,
that's right. What else? What's that? Washing? Yeah. What's that? Lay on it, that's right. Yeah. As a pillow, right. Well, at this, well, I don't really want to like ruin this towel because it's so nicely folded, right? But the scripture doesn't talk about a towel. So it talks about storm, right? So Jesus' disciples, maybe they start the day like really nice, clean, and all beautifully ready for the day, like this towel, really nice, right? But then they were like in a boat, and then there was a storm, and the boat was shaking, just like we just had a really bad rain too, right, this week. And then it's like the towel gets like shaky, and then you twist it, and it's like all not like folded, right? So then what happened? What did the disciples do when they were all scared and everything? Toss them into the water. Yeah, but then there was something else because Jesus was in the boat, right? And then what did they do?
They come up
and then they ask, what did they ask Jesus, right? Help us. This is like, it's stormy. And then what did Jesus do with the storm? It was shaky. And then what happened to the storm? Calm?
Yeah,
right. Yeah, it got calm. And then kind of maybe like this kind of, you know, it's manageable, right? So that's like in our lives when you are feeling shaky or not calm or something heavy in your life and it's like stormy. What do you do? Ask somebody for help. And you don't have to stay in the storm. You can be calling God. Pray to God, and then God will calm your situation. If you're worried, you're scared, like, you know, everything. Yeah, like the boat, like shaky, and it's twisted, like things are so twisted in your life, or you are just stressed of something, know that God will calm your storm, okay? So let us pray. Dear God, thank you for Jesus, who teaches us to pay attention to you, and to know our stormy inside,
and to calm us.
Thank you, God.
Thank you, God.
Amen. Thank you, and blessings, and you can go with Liz for children's service, and then we'll come back later.
Everybody stay calm. This is a familiar story. Disciples are in the ship I like to walk around. I can't just stand here, so you guys already know that, so I might come out at you. So, Jesus tells the disciples, we are going to go over to the other side. In the gospel passages, when we hear the other side, we need to hear it like this. The other side!
Now this might surprise you,
youngsters. I said, good gravy. All right. So you got to climb up this rope in order to even get up there. Can you imagine? I'm a dedicated couch potato, and I'm trying to climb myself up this rope just to get to this platform. Poor little kid down there couldn't even make it. He's crying, face is all red, hyperventilating. I said, my brother, I'm with you. So the other pastors move on, campers move on, but there's one girl who can't go. She's sitting there, she's crying, she's shaking, she says, I can't do it. And her outward expression is displaying everything I feel on the inside. I'm like, yeah, this is stupid. I don't know why they got us up here doing it. And there's no chicken exit. There's no chicken. You got to go through the whole course, and then these crazy people make you go down a zip line to get off of it. Wicked sadists. What are they doing? Why are we doing this? All right, okay. So I'm sitting down next to the girl. You know, I'm doing the pastor pat on her back, and, you know, I'm just trying my best to be a non-anxious presence. Camp counselor is there, and the camp counselor says, I think we need a word of prayer. And I'm like, oh, yeah, yeah, I need prayer. Let's pray, let's pray. And he says, Angela, I said, you want me to pray? What? And I was like, dear God, we're too young to die. In Jesus' name, amen. It was probably a little bit better than that, but that was a non-anxious presence. There's a storm about, and Jesus is sleeping. Another time, I was a non-anxious presence. I don't know if there's any dentist in the congregation. I apologize, but I'm scared of the dentist. I have to be in so much pain in order to go to a dentist's office. Woo, baby. So I'm at a different church. My pastor, Pastor King, this is before I went to seminary. She calls me. She says, Frida needs a ride to the dentist. No, first she said, Frida needs a ride to the doctor. I said, sure, yeah, I'll take her. She says she's going to go to Charles Drew Health Center. Charles Drew is kind of a rough clinic. I said, all right, yeah, I'll still go. Then she drops it. She needs to go to the dentist. I said, oh, the dentist. I said, okay, well, I'm going to bring a book, and I'm just going to sit in the car. So I pick up Frida. We get over there to the clinic. I'm sitting in the car. She said, you're not coming in with me? I said, absolutely not. And she said, please. I said, no. She said, please. I said, all right. So we go in there. We're waiting in the waiting room. They call her name. She says, aren't you coming? I said, heck no, I meant to say. Heck no, I'm not going back there with you. And the dental assistant, she said, oh, that's okay. There's plenty of room. You can come back. And I was like, peace. Okay, so we get back in there. Frida needs to have a tooth pulled. My hand to God, this is what happened. The dentist took out something that looked like a pair of pliers. True story. Straddles the chair, knee on each arm, straddles the chair that Frida's sitting in, and it starts rocking back and forth to get that tooth out. I'm digging through my purse, trying to find some tissue. I'm just holding the tissue on my eyes because I'm crying. I'm trying to be as quiet as I can. That tooth start cracking and stuff. Now I'm sobbing. Frida says, okay, Andy, I can't feel nothing. Okay, Andy, don't cry. Don't cry, Andy, okay. Yeah, I played that pretty cool, I think. Only silent sobs, you know. Okay, let's get back to the boat. Jesus is sleeping, and the disciples are losing their minds like they were in a dentist's office or something like that. Now, some of these disciples were actual fishermen, so if they say the storm is violent, They know what they're talking about. But yet, Jesus is asleep. Do you not care that we are perishing? So now, why is Jesus sleeping? Now, perhaps Jesus wants the disciples to realize that they have power also. Because we do learn later on in Mark's gospel that Jesus gives them power over unclean spirits. So maybe Jesus was waiting for them to try to rebuke some storms in their own lives. Perhaps. Perhaps Jesus was just tired, wanted to lay down. Speaking to parents, you want your kids to talk to you? Try to take a nap. Do you not care that we are perishing, Jesus? There are so many storms in our lives. All kinds of storms. Bullies at school. Bullies at work. I'm not going to get eye contact with anybody. Bullies at church. Bullies at home. Financial struggles, addictions, relationship friction, incarceration, cancer, heart disease, racism. Lord, do you not care that we are perishing? Sexism, ableism, classism, all kinds of discrimination against people because of their sexual orientation. Lord, do you not care that we are perishing? Wars, wars, and rumors of wars. Lord, do you not care that we are perishing? Depression and anxiety. Lord, do you not care that we are perishing? I wonder, when Derek Chauvin had his knee on George Floyd's neck, did Mr. Floyd's spirit cry out, Lord, do you not care that we are perishing? Remember when our neighborhoods were burning down during the uprising? Jesus, do you not care that we are perishing? The reading from Corinthians teaches us that today is the day of salvation. This day right here, right now, today. The good news for us is that we are not powerless. We are not powerless because our Jesus is always present regardless of the storm. Regardless of the storm, Jesus is there. We learned in a previous parable that the harvest grows, whether the farmer is asleep or awake, the seed is going to, Ray Charles said, it's going to do what it do. It's going to do what it do. Whether Jesus was asleep or awake, his powerful presence was there, and it's always with us, regardless of the storms that we go through. Jesus is always present. Do you care that we are perishing? And the answer is always a resounding yes and amen. Yes and amen. Our God cares for each and every one of us. If it's a concern to you, it is a concern to God. Whether it's something that you worry about, it's something that Jesus holds in his hand on your behalf. Do you care that we are perishing? That is always, siblings of the faith, sisters and brothers, friends, beloveds, that answer is always yes, because today is the day of salvation. Do you care that we are perishing? And the answer is yes, and for that, we are thankful. Let the church say, amen. Amen.
My life flows on in endless song, a marvelous lamentation. I catch the sweet, though far off, hymn that hails a new creation. No storm can shake my inmost calm, while to
We come before the triune God to pray for our communities, ourselves, and our world. Equip your faithful people to approach this world with a sense of wonder. Make your church a safe place to explore big questions, troubling doubts, and honest laments. Humble our hearts to repent of the ways that communities of faith have inflicted pain or trauma. God of grace,
hear our prayer.
You spoke creation into order. From the smallest molecules, we are part of that creation. May your name be praised by rivers and seas, wetlands and waterfalls, and by us. Secure clean water for all people. Protect water sources from contamination. God of grace,
hear our prayer.
Amid whirlwinds of division, violence, conflict, remind us again that you are steadfast as the foundations of this earth. Rejuvenate peacemakers. Give strength to advocates. Give wisdom to community organizers when they feel weary in their work. God of grace,
hear our prayer.
Deliver your people from distress, O God. We lift before you all who are sick or struggling, and especially Carmen, Jacintia, and Luke, Bill, Joel, Mary, and their family, Reginald, Hawa, Anton, Noah, Deanna, Mulkey, Mary, and Shane. Grant consolation and peace to all who live with chronic, terminal, or persistent illness. In times of affliction or hardship, sustain us in faith. God of grace,
hear our prayer.
Now is the acceptable time. Now is the day of salvation. Join together with the great cloud of witnesses, we give thanks for your steadfast love and your wonderful works. God of grace,
hear our prayer.
Receive our prayers, O God. Come quickly to our aid and join us in welcoming all who need your love. Through the love of Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
The peace of Christ be with you always.
And also with you.
And let us share that peace with one another.
Peace be with you.
Beautiful sermon, Pastor. Peace be with you. Thank you for the birthday card. God's peace. Peace be with you. Peace carry. Not one. Yeah. Yes. Peace be with you.
Thank you. Give us our daily bread. Give us our daily bread.
Let us pray. Dear God, we give our gifts to you for your kingdom and for the ministry of our church and of our community. Receive them in your name. Amen.
Amen.
God be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to God.
Let us give thanks to the living God. It is indeed right, our duty and our joy, that we should at all times and in all places give thanks and praise to you, Almighty and merciful God, through our Savior, Jesus Christ. And so with all the choirs of angels, with the church on earth and the hosts of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn.
Santo, santo,
santo, santo, santo,
mi corazón te adora,
mi corazón te sabe decir,
santo eres, Señor,
holy, holy,
holy, holy, holy,
my heart.
Blessed are you, O God of the universe. Your mercy is everlasting, and your faithfulness endures from age to age. Praise to you for creating the heavens and the earth. Praise to you for liberating the Israelites from oppression and the promise of all your people throughout the world. Praise to you for the words and deeds of Jesus, your anointed one. Praise to you for the resurrection of Jesus Christ and for your spirit pour out on all people. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread and gave thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sins. Drink this for the remembrance of me." Let us pray together in words both faithful and fresh. God, among us and between us, around and within us, blessed be your names, you the whole, we apart. May every day dawn with a new delight,
and every night grow seeds of justice in our hearts. Feed us today the fruit of our hands and your earth. Forgive us the harm and wrong we do to others, as we forgive the harm and wrong they do to us. Lead us from certainty and cynicism to curiosity and awe, and free us to find you as you are, in all things. Amen.
Everyone is invited to feast at God's table. For those joining us online, hear these words addressed to you, the body of Christ given for you, the blood of Christ shed for you. You may be seated. The ushers will guide you when it's your turn to come forward. You will grab a composable cup on your way up, and there are gluten-free wafers available, so for those who need them, and just ask your server. We have both wine and grape juice, and the wine is dark color, the grape juice is light color, and there is a gold band around it, around the handle, and you are invited to eat and drink, and then deposit your composable cup back to the server. And those who prefer not to commune today but indicate a preference of blessing, just let myself or Pastor Angela know. And then if you have mobility issues, please let the usher know and we will bring the meal to you. Come, Jesus' healing power is here in this meal. All are welcome at Christ's table. Thank you.
Feast of love is offered here. What banquet come from heaven? What food of everlasting life? What gracious gift is given? This is Christ the King.
Yeah. Gracious Lord, take my hand, lead me on, let me stand. I am tired, I am weak, I am worn. Through the storm, through the night, lead me on to the light. Take my hand, precious Lord, lead me on. When my way and the river I stand,
be afraid. My love is stronger. My love is stronger than your fear. Don't be afraid. My love is stronger.
Body and blood of our Savior Jesus Christ strengthen you and keep you in God's grace. Amen. Amen. Please be seated. As we propel by the Holy Spirit into the world to tell the good news, we share these announcements to all of you. Please line up around me here at the podium, and I'll start with a couple of good news. Thank you to Reverend Angela Cabet for that sermon. Oh, wow. Yes, today is the day of salvation. And outside, there are 30 envelopes. We've been asked to help fundraise our other BIPOC youth who are going to New Orleans for MILE and the gathering. And please take one or more envelope. It's similar to how we fundraise. It's based on a number. So if you get envelope number one, you put a dollar, or you could put more than a dollar. And if you like to write a check, please write to Christ River of Life Lutheran Church. And I hope we could pull all the envelopes, the donation, by next week as we are leaving soon to New Orleans. And this Saturday, June 29th, help Kathy Fury to prep meals for the shelter. Meet at the kitchen by 6 o'clock. I will also join during that time. And today, there is Midsummer Fiesta at St. Paul, San Pablo Lutheran Church. It's their annual block party from 12:30 to 3:30 p.m. So it's on 27th Street and 15th Avenue. So after lunch and learn, if you'd like to see, join some fun at the block party, yeah, you could also swing over there. And I'll see you at the Hospitality Center for lunch and learn.
My name is Jeannie Hare, and I'm here on behalf of MCFF telling you about something way in the future, but it's good to plan ahead. August 19th to the 23rd, it's the day camp for South Minneapolis churches, Building Beloved Community. And it is in the Sentinel, so look it up for details. But if you're going into kindergarten or first, second, third, or fifth grade, you are welcome. And there's a special thing for 6th through 8th graders. If you're a high schooler, please consider working at day camp. And if you're like me, come and volunteer. Make a difference in a kid's life. I'll be there. I would love to see some other volunteers. If you have something special, like a craft or something you're good at, music, they'll turn that in and have it there at day camp too. So, in the Sentinel.
Hi, I'm Cynthia Devereaux, and I'm here with two opportunities to join others from our congregation in service. The first is, who'd believe it, but we're running out of plastic bags. So if you've been saving some in your homes, please bring clean plastic bags, and you can put them out in the cloakroom in a big tub out there. The second one is that we have decided, with Pastor Esther's leadership, that we are going to be going over to Camp Nanakazi and feeding 20 people every other Tuesday. Now, you can help in a number of ways. You could bring something. If you give money when we do group purchasing, that's helpful too. But if you feel like making brownies or cookies or something like that, something simple for dessert that's really handheld, that's great. Tuesday is the next time we are going over. We'll be gathering here probably about 4 o'clock to put the meal together. This time we are serving hot dogs and baked beans and coleslaw and probably a piece of fruit and then some sort of sweet thing, because they're all diabetic, but they love their sweets. So we want to make them happy as well. But let Pastor Esther know if you're able to come over and help on Tuesday. Thanks.
David Shea for the Isaiah team. We're going to meet a week from tomorrow night on Monday, July 1st, and 7 to 8:30 here at the church. Normally we meet on the second Monday of the odd-numbered months, but this time in summer we're meeting on the 1st, July 1st. I hope you can make it. See you here at church, 7 o'clock Monday night.
Armin Abrahamson for the garden crew. First fruits, literally, and some arugula too. They're out in the narthex. Service berries, Nanking cherries, currants, strawberries are all ripening. Go out and pick some yourself. I left some containers by the door of the shed for you to be able to pick things into. If you want to join us tomorrow, Monday night at 6, we'll try to share some of that with anyone from the shelter who's interested.
Hi, my name's Angela Cobb. The church has books for the graduates. Joe Davis's book of poetry, We Rise Higher. So I don't know people's faces well enough, but see me and I'll make sure that you get your book, graduate.
Hi, Nancy Niger Johnson. Two things for you to think about for this coming week. One is on Thursday night at 7 p.m. at the Como Park Pavilion. The band that I play in, the Robbinsdale City Band, is playing a concert there. It is a really fun place to play at. It's a nice big stage, whatever. I mean, it's very nice. They have a nice food place there too, so if you want to come and eat something before the concert. Hopefully, we got rained out this past week, so hopefully we get to play this week. And then we have communion bread baking this coming Saturday at 9 a.m. till about 11 in the kitchen. No experience necessary. If you've ever wondered how we make our communion bread, come that day and see how it works. If you're a little kid, feel free to come as long as you bring a parent. If you're younger, older kids, that's fine. Yeah, it's always a great time. And next Sunday, we'll have fresh bread. So that's always, come next Sunday so you can have fresh bread. And then something for in the more of the future, Lutheran Night at Target Field is Monday, August 12th. Please sign up on the sign-up sheet that is out on that table right as you kind of come in the front door. And now Mary has
something. And I have something from over here at this station. Yesterday was Pastor Esther's 50th birthday. And one of her favorite things to eat are the eclairs from Butter Bakery. So we have some out in the narthex. But first, shall we sing?
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Esther. Happy birthday to you.
Thank you so much. Please rise for the blessing. This is the faith which we proclaim. The power of God, which created the world, is the power of love. The power in Jesus, which rescues the world, is the power of love. The power in us, which changes the world, is the power of love. Therefore, I bless you. In the name of love, the anointing of the Spirit remains upon you now and forever. Amen. Amen.